Harry Kane problem could be worse for Liverpool despite barely believable Pep Guardiola claim. The England captain looks set to join either one of the Manchester clubs or Chelsea. But which would be the worst outcome from the perspective of the Reds? The eyes of the world will be fixed upon the Copa America and European Championship finals this weekend. Argentina will look to win their first continental title since 1993 when they take on Brazil. While Italy are hoping to become champions of Europe for the first time since England were World Cup holders. It has been a while. But whatever the outcomes when the matches are over, so is the 2019-20 season. Focus can finally switch to the most important business of all. The transfer market. Yes, the transfer market. Some football fans seem to care more about winning the transfer window rather than accumulating actual trophies. There's one man who wants to win some silverware in his career, though, and his potential move will dominate the summer until his future is decided. England captain Harry Kane has decided he has had enough of Tottenham Hotspur being an early team. He wants to be at a club where he can lift the big trophies. While his destination is not going to be Liverpool, the Reds will be affected by which team Kane signs for, as he will inevitably improve them in 2021-22. Or will I? Let's look at Kane's three most likely options and consider the ramifications for Liverpool. Manchester City. Despite Pep Guardiola's protestations that the Premier League champions are being priced out of the market for a new striker, few people will believe him. If they can purchase Kane, it will mark a departure of sorts from the last couple of seasons in that they'll be able to select an elite finisher up front on a regular basis. Gabriel Jesus almost always underperforms against his expected goal numbers. And he got 20 of the 40 center forward starts Guardiola handed out in the league in 2020-21, with 19 the year before. Aguero would have played more but for injuries, of course, and Kane rarely gets through a season without a spell on the sidelines. Butashe has shown he can drift deeper and play more as a false nine than previously, he would fit in well at City. Manchester United. Any United fans who harbor hopes of their team signing Kane must have been watching England's 4-0 win over Ukraine with interest. As it was the only match that Don Sancho has started at 2020 de Euro. But there was no connection between the two, at least in terms of creating chances. And the current Dortmund man hasn't ever assisted Kane at international level. While Sancho's baffling lack of opportunities with England obviously plays into that, it does raise an interesting conundrum for United. No club can ever have too many great players, but multiple new signings may not automatically catch fire immediately either. With little time to prepare for 2021 pe 22, there's a chance they may lose early ground if trying to integrate both Sancho and Kane. Equally, when your whole attacking strategy appears to be, give it to Bruno Fernandes and counter-attack, then maybe it doesn't matter. Chelsea. Between the appointment of Thomas Tuchel and the end of the season, Chelsea had the best defensive record in the Premier League. It will be interesting to see if they can maintain these wins. Normal football, intense matches played in full stadiums, gets underway once more. However, when your top scorer only got 7 goals, and they were all from the penalty spot, you know at which end of the pitch your true problems lie. Only 7 of the 97 other teams in Europa's Big 5 leagues had. A bigger negative discrepancy between their expected goals and goals scored this season, perf bref. As Chelsea were ranked 16th for XG, there was no lack of chances, just a lack of them being put away. Kane would likely solve this almost immediately, so a move across London would appear to be the worst outcome from a Liverpool perspective. But let's be honest, in the long term none of these scenarios look great, do they?